films here, Lagos supported the production of those films, like 93 Days, which is one of the eight, and the CEO, you know, which was here for Kunle in on the stage of In Conversation With, and then having his film being screened, you know, for the private screening. So Lagos State supported a good number of actors and producers from those, you know, two films in particular, in addition to the all the other people that were brought here to say, let the key people in the industry, from the Nollywood industry, let them come and see how things are done so that they can transfer knowledge, bring back knowledge, you know, to Nollywood and to Lagos State so that Lagos can be the better for it. Our aim is for Lagos to be the destination, to be the hub, you know, to be the main location so that all the money don't go to South Africa or go to Cairo or go to Marrakesh in Morocco, but to market Lagos, to market Badagry, to market Ekpe, you know, as destination with all the safety and security apparatuses that we are putting in place, tax incentives that we are introducing, and everything that will make Lagos desirable as a film location.
I know Lagos cannot, you know, fight piracy in all over the country, but what are they doing to actually fight piracy in Lagos, especially in Alaba?
During the campaign that brought in President Muhammadu Buhari was the issue of piracy. And that question was posed directly, you know, at the president. And the president was, you know, magnanimous enough to say that he was interested in that concern. And about 3 or 4 months ago, I recall that, you know, he enlisted the support of all the service chiefs and especially the Inspector General of Police to assist the industry in the fight against piracy. Not only as it affects filmmakers, but all the entire gamut of the arts, those who are writing books, books piracy, music piracy, film piracy, and Lagos as the hub of production and distribution of this material, you know, we are in sync with what the federal government is doing, with what President Buhari, you know, has said, and Governor Akinwumi Ambode is ready, the Commissioner of Police in Lagos State is ready, and we're putting together a whole load, working with the Association of Movie Producers, working with distributors, working with the directors to say that let us look at a different approach, you know, to how we can tackle piracy, not just hounding those who are the who are, you know, hawking the goods, but to go to the source and deal with it. But we need the support of everybody, including the practitioners and the stakeholders, and we're happy that in particular the Association of Movie Producers say that they are in full support of the law of Lagos State that restricts street hawking from major highways and major streets, because if the outlets are not there for people to buy at 150, it means that we will have half that danger by 50%. But then we will now go a lot further, working with the federal agencies, working with the federal attorney general, working with the Inspector General of Police to ensure that we begin a lasting process that will stamp out piracy.
Okay, what is the state doing to make sure that this is maintained yearly for Lagos to be represented here at the Toronto International Film Festival?
Toronto is not the only film festival in the world. There are several important film festivals that Lagos State needs to be, that Nigerian filmmakers need to be. Cannes is there, Berlin is there, Pan-African Film Festival in Los Angeles, Durban Film Festival, and Lagos should also use this opportunity to draw people. It's reciprocal, to draw people to his own festival, whether it is the Abuja International Film Festival, which is in its 13th, I believe, edition this year, or the African Film Festival, which is now domiciled in Lagos. We should also begin to attract people to come, you know, to bring, you know, all the wherewithal that festival goers, you know, go with to Lagos. So it is not just about coming to Toronto on a yearly basis. I mean, I told you that the last time we were here in a big way was 3 years ago when Half of a Yellow Sun premiered. Before then, it was 10 years ago when Tunde Kilani's Abeni, you know, premiered here. Now we have had 8 films. The whole point will now be to say, what do we do, you know, after this one? It shouldn't just be about Toronto alone. Yes, Lagos will return to Toronto. Yes, Nollywood will come back to Toronto, but they will go elsewhere and also indeed draw other people to come to Lagos and be part of what we're doing.
I know that there is a stand, I mean, meant for Nigerians to actually come together, talk about what they've got, and unite to do one or two things here in Toronto as one group.
Yes.
Shall we go there?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
The last time, as far as I know, that we had a stand or a pavilion, if you like this, was 10 years ago in 2006, when the NFC had a stand. But that year, we had only one major film, Abeni, by Tunde Kilani. And then there was also another theme on the sideline, Farouk Lasaki's film. That year, only one journalist was here in Toronto. The only person from government who got a visa to come here was the MD of the Nigerian Film Corporation, Mr. Afolabi Adesanya, you know. But 3 years ago when we came, when we participated, not as Lagos State government, but as Nigeria, there was no stand, there was no pavilion. There was a film, Half of a Yellow Sun, you know, a co-production, if you like, between Nigeria and the UK, but nowhere to call the home of Nollywood as at that time. So it's an important requirement so that people can feel free to come around, to conduct businesses, to collect their mails and letters, to relax after watching films or attending conferences, etc. You know, and you can see from our neighbors, this is Jamaica to the left, this is Israel to the right, this is South Africa is there, France is over there, Russia is over there. It is an important requirement if you are going to be at a film festival, because for us as Lagos State, it is not just about the film. This is also a base to sell our state. Every information that people will require, about Lagos as a film destination, about tourism opportunities in Lagos, about visiting Lagos State, this is where you will get that information. So there is a component of information there, of arts, of culture, of tourism, and of course film, naturally. So this is the base. This is Lagos in Toronto, and I'm sure in the last 1 week, everybody has seen that this is
because
great.
I want to ask you the kind of feedback that you've been getting.
Great, fantastic. I mean, you can see that filmmakers come here, government officials are here, film exhibitors are here. Anybody that has something to do with Nigeria, you know, will come here to make inquiries, you know, and of course we dish out information. If you need to watch, you know, screeners of Nigerian films, you get from here. Publications about the state, about tourism, about film, you know, about anything you need to know at all, you know, you find it here. You know, even if we still ultimately need to direct you to those that you need to speak to or online. So the feedback has been great, and you could see that, you know, all the 8 films selected were represented, you know, here. So it's not just about, you know, Lagos. This is about what Lagos has to offer. All the 8 films, and then the CEO that is, you know, having a special screening. Everybody is here. This is home to everybody.
Yeah, and I can also see the Commissioner for Justice, Adeniji Kazeem,
yes,
also here.
Yeah,
let me just ask him one or two questions. I know you've been here for some days now. What has been your feedback so far?
Well, the feedback has been very good. I mean, as I can see, I'm at the Lagos stand. It's very colorful. It ranks at the same level with any of the other stands that are here. It shows that Lagos is very well represented, and Lagos is up to the proper standards that any booth should have. So the feedback, also from what I've seen, at least in the movies that I've attended from the crowd, is that I've been very well received. It shows that if Nigerian movies can be screened at this level at a major film festival like this, it shows clearly that Nigeria is now ready to operate at the international stage. It's just for us now to raise the bar even higher and win some international film awards to send the message clearly that we have arrived.
is an opportunity for Lagos to be here. This is actually being driven by the Ministry of Tourism, Arts and Culture, which is why you are the special advisor to the Governor on Arts and Culture here, the Permanent Secretary, you know, from the Ministry, you know, and a few, you know, officers. The whole idea is that Toronto is getting it right as a livable city, as a city of film, as a destination. There are a few things that Lagos too can learn, you know, from Toronto. And that is part of the reason why the Lagos stand here is not just about film, it's also about marketing Lagos as a destination. We want people to come to our hotels, we want people to come and invest. You know that the governor is interested in turning Badagry, you know, into the hub of hospitality business. People are interested, and we have gotten, you know, so many inquiries and interest that we believe that in due course we begin to translate into what will turn Lagos into the destination that we all desire, you know, as the number one in terms of entertainment, culture and hospitality, not only in Africa, but anywhere in the black world. Because with 21 million people, we keep saying it, Lagos is home to the largest concentration of black people anywhere in the world.
Already. Don't forget that Toronto International Film Festival is a charitable cultural organization whose mission is to transform the way people see the world through film. And on that note, we say bye-bye from Toronto, Canada, and see you next time in Lagos. I'm Adedoja Salam Adeniyi. Many thanks for being there.